Alright, so I dragged this thing home, try to play around with it. I was thinking about trying to clean it up and maybe sell it if it wouldn't take too much work. This is a, I guess this was their top of the line at the time. This is a Magnavox from 1978. All the build date codes inside this thing are 1978. But this was not in the 1978 catalog. I think it was in the 77. Something similar to it. But from the little bit of research that I was able to do, I believe this is a 12-watt amplifier. It's supposed to have a separate power transformer. And they have down here is your basic, the phono is automatic on. You have your internal and external speakers, loudness, all these controls need to be cleaned. And then just your basic volume, balance, bass, treble, selectors. The turntable is one of the last Collaros. Looks like a BSR in a lot of ways, but it is a Collaro. It's a W747. And we have probably, I guess that's anti-skate on the side. We have the adjustable pressure. It's got a cued damper on it. You raise it up and you drop the lever. It is a cued damper. It's a nice unit. It's a nice unit. Precision Instrument by Magnavox Great Britain. Well, this Precision Instrument, here's the model tag off of it. Date coded 10th week of 1978. I've done some minimal, because I don't have any kind of workshop set up here. I've done some minimal work to get it functioning. And the problem that it has is, let me pick a record that most people would be familiar with. Got this Herb Alpert record here. Let's see. Now that the changing mechanism is all gummed up, it doesn't automatically drop or anything, but we do have it running. Well, come on. Okay, this is strange. Well, let's see what it sounds like. Funny, it sounds all right now, but I think it may be running it historically. Since I started working with this thing, it runs a tad bit slow, and after, if you just let the turntable run for 10 or 15 minutes and drop a record on it, it's normal. But of course, I go to do this video demonstration and I haven't ran this damn thing in 3 or 4 days, and I don't have a strobe disc on it. It sounds like it's all right. Okay, well, before I get a copyright strike. So, this cabinet was originally white. As we can see where I've tried to polish through a couple of areas. Now it's all a yellowish beige. I don't think it's nicotine, because I've tried all your normal stuff and I think it just aged yellowed over the years. I really do not think this is nicotine stained. And there was no nicotine stains on any of this inside. This thing was stored in a dirty area. And gosh, I ain't gonna be able to see if the grill cloth is stained on the sides. So my whole reason of wondering how far to continue with this project was, well, I mean, I can do some more work on the record player, that's not a big deal. But that was the problem there. The 8-track Magnavox had 3 different units that would sit in here. Oop, I just pulled the damn knob off. This was your 8-track unit, or, you know, any optional tape unit that there was. This was just I think an album would fit down there. I don't know, but this was a storage bin. You could buy it just like this with nothing in there. There's a little felt liner on the bottom. And if we look on the side of this, it tells you the color coding for the wires. Made in Japan. Here's your tag with the model numbers and all. And let's see if I got this plug. I don't think this was plugged in.
I got it.
Let's see. Magnavox tape units, blah blah blah, may be installed in this unit. Well, here's a for the service technician only. And this is just basically a wiring hookup between everything. So I'll have to bring the none of this tape stuff is hooked up, so let's see. Let's hook this up to the tape play. Don't worry about the recording stuff. This is plugged in. What do we got back here? Antenna, auxiliary tape, external speakers, and power. Alright. So now this is how it goes in. There ain't no clips or anything. It just sits down in here. Supposed to get the wires out the way and drop it down in where it goes. Alright, so let's try out the tape. It looks like it ought to work. Well, I hear the motor running. There's not much else going on. Tracks aren't changing. Fast forward works. So the belt's gone. Yeah, this is funny. See if I can catch this. How this works. To take the tape out, you have to hold this release button in and then pull it out. So the 8-track needs a belt. Try to get this light around the other side here. We'll have a look. See what we can see in the back of this thing. This has the speakers encased in the big styrofoam cocoons. Of course, this is that record bin. Now to get to this is a model 6748. It's a model 6748. Of course, the whole thing is, it's got some lot of particle board. This thing's heavy. See if we can look. So we got the woofers, and then I guess a 4-inch mid and a 3.5-inch tweeter up there. Still have a pilot light.
Hey, you gotta get that bin out of the way to remove the... Well, so they say. I think I could get this out, but it would be easier with the bin removed, but... Try to put the camera back here. I'm kind of working blind. So I'll have a good look at this thing for the first time myself. So this was... And we got a big heat sink there. I thought this thing had a transformer. I guess I'm wrong. I don't know what the heck I was looking at before. Oh, there it is. I did see one. Well, anyhow. There's our speaker compliment. The record changer does have a four-pole motor. Well, with this, I never degreased any of the cycling mechanism yet. You know... Thing about this girl is that it sounds rather decent, even though it's a end of the line, you know, well past their prime type of unit. Gotta clean the switches, but oh, there's another problem too. The stereo, and it might be a dirty switch, but the stereo never plays in stereo.
He was a good guy. It was obvious that he and Ada loved each other.
It's Tripod Trivia, September 12th, 7 p.m., mshumanities.org. The humanities are for everyone.
The dollar. Is this a concern? Well, it should.
Nutrition.
I ain't got no type like Jimmy and Sway Lee, but if he can't.
Welcome around to the afternoon here on Magic 93.7. Hang in. We've got a whole hour coming up commercial free. And
there's a bunch of radio stations that I pick up at the new house up here out of Hattiesburg. In the Gulf Coast, and I have no clue what they are. So normally I would dial through and know exactly what I was hitting after living the majority of my life in metropolitan New Orleans. And I'll have to write out a station guide or something to see the kind of things that I should be able to pick up out of these markets. But yeah, Magic 93.7, no clue.
That are here at the Harrison County. Introducing Big Night In Bundle, 25 boneless wings, and your choice of three craveable flavors and three delicious dips, all for just $15.99. Tonight, the big game is on. Show Binge Beckons. So get lemon pepper, OG hot, mango habanero, and any of Wingstop's legendary flavors. Introducing Wingstop's Big Night In Bundle, 25 boneless wings, and your choice of three craveable flavors and three delicious dips, all for just $15.99. Order yours tonight at wingstop.com at any percent.
it.
Wingstop.
Can't stop. Wingstop. Baton Rouge's number one for hip-hop.
It's your boy, Young TZ, you already know.
What's up? This is Beyonce.
Max 94.1.
Now, really, there's no reason that I should be picking up Baton Rouge radio stations. I guess it's... Hello. I'm making a little movie on this whole thing. All right. Yeah, there's no reason I should be picking up a Baton Rouge radio station. I'm even farther out than where I was, but I might be more directly east of Baton Rouge now without the signal having to cross through New Orleans. I don't know. Here's Tix FM, the standard. We're kind of on the fringes for Tix FM up here, but it comes in fine.
The Lake, 94.7.
That's a station out of Hammond or something. I have no clue what that is.
This program has been used by thousands to leak.
Junior and Jill at the House of Blues on Thursday, September 20th at 6 p.m.
Oh, if today God should call you away.
A gospel station. I have no clue where this is.
In exchange for your soul.
Up a lot more radio stations, I guess, pulling from three markets. But this is funny. I haven't heard some of these type of songs in years. Eddie Grant.
Solid as rock, honest, truthful. This is the Sean Hannity Show.
In part by The Book at Harris Gulf Coast in Biloxi. Turn any day.
That's WWLFM 105. Freaky tuner.
Without a doubt, the best reason is the service. Remember that old-time personal service you used to get at your hometown drugstore? It's still alive and well at City Rexall Drugs in Picayune. Mr. John and his staff at City Rexall Drugs takes pride...
Well, this is the local, the one local radio station up here, 1320. And it's coming in fully pegged on the meter, but...
...are now eligible for Medicare.
companystore.com and enter code radio 15.
Yeah, the AM isn't quite as sensitive,
but your entire order and
yeah, I agree.
Yeah, it just
It just doesn't.
Although what it's picking up right here is 990 WGSO out of New Orleans, which is very weak, very hard to get up here, and at least
destroyer. And there is a point which it's a sweet spot where it belongs. I
there's a lot of background noise, but it's perfectly understandable.
What are they trying to do here? This doesn't work with this grade.
I'm not going to bother trying to align something like this.
At your fantasy football league, they have all the draft kits.
870.
Audacity to.
Funeral home. Shane Funeral Home in the heart.
Imagine a party where the wine didn't flow.
All right, well. Here's a little band spin and 21 minutes. 21 minutes and this thing isn't even doing anything. So, I guess I'll finish degreasing the turntable. Seeing what I can do with that. Like I said, it sounds darn good for what it is. I hate to put it like that. It's a real good sounding unit. You know, it's not a $800... you know, tube unit from the early 60s, but I mean, especially for, you know, one of these, you know, 70s modern, you know, for what console stereos had become, you know, this is still as good a quality sonically as you'd get out of anything that you could hope to by the end of the 70s. Don't know what you'd do with cabinet damage like this, you know. Particle board, and you can sand it down, I guess, and try to repaint the whole sucker. This thing is just painted. It's not a, well, I don't know if you can make that look decent or not. But that's what I've been playing around with. And I'm going to have to trim this video down because it's going on way too long. Alrighty.